welcome to a brand new round of box office predictions. Of course, right off the top, we do our Fantasy Movie League recap. And before I even give these two individuals a shout out here, special thanks to anybody who shared some kind words about the Fantasy Movie League ad that you might have seen playing before select movies this weekend. It was really exciting to have that happen, and all your positive feedback really just means a lot to me. So thank you guys for sharing that with me if you caught it in theaters. Now, we've got two players in the Predictions with Perri League who scored that perfect lineup. Those two players this week are Gaps and Vincent Gambini. Huge congrats to the two of you. I kind of climbed in the rankings just a little bit. I could have used for a better Fantasy Movie League score last time, but hopefully this time I might nail it. My numbers with my top five were fairly okay. I missed a couple, but I was just really happy to see Bohemian Rhapsody not just exceed my expectations, but kind of crush them. I can't believe how big it opened. Of course, we know that one is the one that topped the charts with $51.1 million. I was right on the money with The Nutcracker and The Four Realms, which kicked off its run with $20.4 million. But now here's where my rankings are thrown off, because Halloween's decline was way steeper than I thought. In the number three position, it was Nobody's Fool with $13.7 million. Then it was A Star Is Born, which held on super well, dropping a mere 21.6% and making another $11 million. And then finally at number five, that's where we have Halloween, because it took $10.8 million after a fairly hefty 65.5% drop. This weekend, predicting the 5, 4, and 3 spots could be pretty challenging, because I think all three movies could wind up with similar amounts, but I am committing to The Nutcracker and The Four Realms for my number 5 spot. Yeah, it did have a pretty rough start, and there is no doubt that The Grinch is gonna eat into its viewership this weekend, but the movie did kick off its run with about $20 million, so even if it loses, let's say 58%, very similar to another Disney disappointment, The BFG, when that movie came out, it's still making about $8.5 million, but for The Nutcracker, I do think the holiday spirit is gonna give it a little boost, and it could wind up bringing that percent change down to about 50%. And if that's what winds up happening, this one is gonna take that number five spot with $10 million. This next movie was actually in my number three spot when I first started drafting my predictions for this week, but I'm switching it up a little. It might be a bold prediction, might throw off my rankings a bit, but my number four this time around is The Girl in the Spider's Web. Maybe I'm just not in the right place at the right time, but I really feel like this movie is kind of getting lost in the mix, and I do think it could wind up being a pretty big disappointment for Sony, even though the production budget for this is reported to be at about $43 million, which is significantly less than that David Fincher movie. That one cost $90 million to make, and that movie opened in 2011 and made $12.8 million opening weekend. But considering the amount of competition this new movie is facing, and also the fact that it's got significantly less buzz, I have a feeling it's coming in under that number. And right now, I have The Girl in the Spider's Web taking the number four spot with just $11 million. Now it's on to what I wound up settling on for my number three pick. It's Overlord. I really want to find time to see this one this weekend, and I have a feeling it might be the same for some of you out there, but I don't know if it's gonna be enough people to make this a really big surprise box office hit, especially with Halloween in October in the rearview mirror. I'm not saying that come the holiday season, horror movies or other genre movies can't do well, but I think it's kind of prime time for feel-good family movies, and it doesn't seem like Overlord fits in that mold whatsoever. In order to figure this one out, though, I'm looking at the movie Skyline. You might remember that one. It starred Eric Balfour. That one came out in 2011, right about the same time of year, and it wound up making $11.7 million. With Overlord, though, that movie's got way better reviews than what Skyline had, so the buzz might actually help it here. So I actually have it just topping Skyline's $11.7 million, and I'm giving Overlord an even $12 million. The number two spot is a pretty easy call this weekend. It's Bohemian Rhapsody. Not only did this one post a huge opening weekend number, but it also got that A Cinema score, and you guys know what that means at this point. It means the movie could have some seriously long legs and make a lot of money over its entire theatrical run. Looking at, let's say, A Star Is Born, that movie in weekend two, it dropped just 33.7%. But Bohemian Rhapsody does have a little more competition. It's got The Grinch, Overlord, and of course, The Girl in the Spider's Web. So that'll be working against it. Plus, it obviously has a little more to lose. But even if that percent change, let's say, comes up to 40%, we're still talking about a $30 million weekend two for Bohemian Rhapsody. Now it is time for my number one of the weekend, and of course that goes to Illumination Entertainment's The Grinch. Remember how The Nutcracker and The Four Realms didn't have the hottest start last weekend? That is going to come in handy for The Grinch this time around. Plus, we're over a month away from the release of Smallfoot. It is a good time for a brand new studio animated film, and of course, holiday time, that's when you release a Grinch movie. We all know that Illumination Entertainment has released some very, very successful movies over the past few years. Most of those movies have come out during the summertime, so I do think that we could see a little bit of a lower number for The Grinch for that reason, but I still think it's got a very good shot at actually coming close to another Illumination Dr. Seuss adaptation in The Lorax. That movie, when it opened up, it took $70 million, and I've got The Grinch coming in right behind that with $65 million of its own. It's time for that recap now. I have The Grinch topping the charts with $65 million. Then it's Bohemian Rhapsody at number two with $30 million. I've got Overlord coming in at number three with $12 million. The Girl in the Spider's Web following right behind with $11 million. And then finally at number five, The Nutcracker and The Four Realms with $10 million. There it is, guys. Those are my predictions. Now, of course, I leave it to you. Hit that comment section below. Share your top five right there. Also, don't forget, Fantasy Movie League. Go make your lineup right now. And you know what? I read the comments. I'm going to remind you right now that the link and the password for the Predictions with Perri League, it's in the description section of this video. So if you are not already signed up, use that to get that done. Now, of course, we've got some Patreon shoutouts, and I have a big group to celebrate today. They are longtime supporters, Evan, Jack, Kavi, Michael, Ryan, and Gregory. You might see some of those names circle back again soon because I've got a brand new Q&A video coming your way very soon now, and a couple of these names that I just read off are on that tier of the Patreon campaign, so if you want to take part, jump in. You could find the link to the Patreon campaign below. Check out all the cool rewards, and again, to all the guys that I just listed, a huge thank you for sticking with the campaign for so long. It really is important to me to have you guys such a big part of the community, so thank you for being here. Thanks to everybody out there for watching this video. Don't forget to like and share, and I'll see you next week for more box office predictions.